I'm Jon Caldara, president of the Independence Institute, and your devil's advocate. Later on, we're going to talk about, well, police overstepping their bounds. But first, well, kick back and have a smoke, and let's talk about the war on smokers. Mary Szarmach has been a friend for a long time. I got to tell you, I am such a fan of the company your family built called Smoker Friendly. You guys sell an evil, awful product to evil, awful people, smokers. So while cannabis shops are popping up everywhere, to the delight of everyone, your shops are being put out of business, locality by locality, throughout the state by the new laws. First, let me just ask you about what I perceive as a real war against smokers. I enjoy the occasional cigar, and I got some. tell me about how awful it is being a smoker.
Well, yeah.
Aren't you self-loathing?
we must be self-loathing. We try to be, you know, a good, responsible retailer of an adult commodity that's highly taxed, highly regulated, and, by the way, legal.
Right.
So, you know, it is at every turn, especially with the local municipalities now popping up ordinances daily, practically. It's been a bit of a battle.
It's so odd that we celebrate craft breweries and all the places that you can get infused liquor and the distilleries that are popping up in Colorado, and that's Colorado proud. And you can get a flavored vodka now that's infused with vanilla, but we're going to outlaw vaping that's infused with any flavor. So mm-hmm. I can get my vanilla cannabis, I can get my vanilla whiskey and vodka, but I can't get vanilla infused juice for my vapor.
Nope, that's a fact. And coming up in Boulder this week, I think it happened actually this week.
Then not because your family lives in Boulder. I mean,
we're fourth generation Native family.
Right. This is Colorado, mm-hmm. and the Gallagher family has been part of the growth of the state, but no more. All right. Mm-hmm. Here's the politics behind it.
Okay.
The legislature passed, I think it was 1303, I'm trying to remember.
1033.
Yep. Close enough. Mm-hmm. And it was on this disguise of local control that localities can now can do their own regulations.
Mm-hmm.
What a lie. That it has nothing to do with local control, because local control means you'd be able to remove regulatory hurdles, lower taxes. It can only go in one direction, more and more. Mm-hmm. So let's take Boulder first. Okay. What happened in Boulder?
Okay, so the original proposal read such that they would add $4 a pack, a ballot initiative for $4 a pack on cigarettes. Keep in mind that at the federal level, a carton of cigarettes is taxed at $10.20, and at the state level at $8.40. So they were talking about another $40 a carton on cigarettes above and beyond those two.
Stop there for a second. So I buy a carton of cigarettes. How many boxes of cigarettes in a carton?
Ten.
Ten. Mm-hmm. And I'm paying $1.80 in taxes already.
Mm-hmm.
Per pack.
And change, yeah.
And so now they want to move that to $4.80, which I'm not a good at economics, but what does that do to your business as somebody who sells this legal product?
Well, what happens is, I mean, we don't sell cigarettes in Boulder anymore.
It closes
but,
down
you
your
know,
business.
You can still go to Longmont and pay the $1.80 tax that currently sits on the product, or maybe Louisville or Lafayette. And as you know, living in Boulder, we have a lot of commuters that come into town every day, and we actually did a small sampling of that during this to show the city council the amount of people we had over in just literally, I don't know, 12 days, we had over 980 signatures of people that said they would choose to buy their tobacco products, including other tobacco products, cigarettes, and vaping products elsewhere.
Right. I think Boulder likes to think that they live in this little island nation and that when they outlaw cigarette smoking, that nobody else around them. But they're right in a way. And the reason this law was passed was for those outliers like Aurora and Boulder to start basically outlawing your business so that there's a patchwork of laws so that a future generation of politicians go, we've got to do something about all this local control and bring it in with a statewide thing. Why was this tax increase necessary? It was to stop what problem?
Well, it was all under the auspices of vaping and teen vaping and the epidemic of teen vaping. But then, you know,
Wait. Let me see if I understand this, because I've heard about the epidemic of teen vaping. So because there are teens vaping, we're going to tax adults when they buy tobacco.
Exactly.
So let me see. That's the logic. We're going to stop teen vaping by taxing adults for a completely different product.
So Boulder backed off of the 40% on other tobacco similar to the product you're holding in your hand, and they backed off of the ballot.
Brand from Smoker Friendly, by the way. You also do your own cigars now, too.
That's right. Well, and so they backed off of both of those ballot initiatives, but there will be a ballot initiative for 40% tax on vaping and any vaping-type products. Vaping currently is not taxed at the state or federal level. We've encouraged the state for 2 or 3 years now. We've asked different legislators to take this to the state and go to the ballot, and you know it should fairly be taxed. The product, we're fine with that. We're not crazy.
Really, what you want? Let me read between the lines. Really, what you want is say, hey, give me one set of rules statewide.
Yes, that
I'm
we can
trying
live
to
with.
Run a business that has outlets throughout the state. Give me one set of rules instead of potentially hundreds and hundreds of sets of rules that
will be unworkable.
Right,
and the unintended consequences that. Of many of these ordinances that the city councils don't think about are the flavor bans. That's another big one now. Well, when they were talking flavor ban in Boulder, they were certainly looking at vaping. And again, teen vaping. Illegal vaping, by the way, because it is illegal for anyone.
How old do you have to be? You have to be 18 to buy any tobacco product, right?
That's correct.
Now, and localities now can raise that age.
They sure can. Right. And Boulder did.
Under this new law.
To 21, as did Glenwood Springs, several smaller cities up in Moffat County, Aspen, Basalt.
Yeah, of course. The rich elitist towns did this.
Right. I guess that's fine. The one thing that the tobacco-free kids can't tell us is
what is tobacco-free kids?
It's an anti-organization.
It's an anti-organization.
Tobacco. Yeah.
Right.
But they can never tell you what are the results of changing from 18 to 21. Has that really curbed youth from vaping? Well, the FDA tells us no, that can't be, because 89% of the youth are getting it from social sources and or the internet. And there was a young man that spoke at the city council meeting in Boulder, and he wrote a story, and it's going to come out, and I told him I'm going to put it in our stores, and it's called The Big Puff. And he said, we go to Target, buy a gift card, and we can buy anything we want on the internet, and you get around the age verification situation, apparently. But they are in turn going to, you know, take it against their local businesses, their local retailers, their family businesses in our case. There's going to be up to 8 stores that actually go out of business, vape stores in Boulder, that, you know, are legal. They were good legal businesses, family businesses. They had leases. They had employees, you know. And it just seems very unfair to me. And
it's not just unfair; it is downright intolerant, which is what Boulder is. Boulder is, I believe, the most hateful, bigoted, intolerant, elitist town in Colorado. They'll never see that. And while they talk about, you know, we want to celebrate diversity, we want to celebrate inclusion and tolerance, well, if you're a gun owner like me breaking the law, they don't want you there. If you smoke a cigar, apparently they don't want you there either. And if you're an adult having a vape, they don't want you there either.
Absolutely.
So what tolerance? Let's call it for what it is. It's bigotry and it's hateful. If they treated the marijuana industry this way, people would be up in arms. If they treated the craft brewing industry this way, people would be up in arms. If they took the distilleries that are popping up throughout Denver this way, people would be rightfully up in arms. Mm-hmm. But smokers are easy to beat up on because you're a minority, a political minority, and nobody comes to your rescue. Mm-hmm. And I find it so objectionable.
Yes.
All right, so we're running out of time. Let me ask this question.
Okay.
So the kids are buying a product, getting their hands on a product. Mm-hmm. And what they're doing is beating up on adults who are not buying the product and not, that are buying for themselves. It sounds like to me like you're angry at your kid for running up your credit card, so you kick the dog, which has nothing to do with the kid. What conversations have there been to punish underage kids who are vaping or who have the product? They're the ones breaking the law.
I'm glad you asked that question, John, because nothing, absolutely nothing. And all of the organizations, including the parents groups and the anti-tobacco organizations, say, oh, no, we could never have a consequence that would maybe put something on a child's record just because of vaping. But yet we have minors in possession with alcohol. We have minors in possession with marijuana. If there's going to be no consequences for possessing and using the product, then what good does it do to have any rules? I just don't understand that. I will say the funny little quick story, the athletic director at Boulder High School, which we are all proud graduates of, even including my father, he got up just after we made a very large donation, actually, to the Boulder High School football team. We're probably one of the largest athletic donors for that school. He stood up and said that tobacco merchants in the city of Boulder are no different than heroin dealers.
Wow. So, no different than
heroin. I don't
even
look like a heroin dealer, do I?
Don't buy the packaging. Don't buy the packaging. All right, we've only got a minute here, but
okay.
The same sort of hijinks is happening in Aurora. Mm-hmm. And whether you like smokers or not, Aurora came up with a wonderful way to raise taxes on tobacco without going to the people. At least Boulder is going to go to the people, and they're so elitist that they'll probably pass it. In Aurora, instead of going to the people, they changed the definition of a tax exemption. The state taxes us at a really high rate, mm-hmm. and then distributes that to the cities.
Right.
And therefore, cities don't collect sales tax on this, usually. Mm-hmm. They decided, I tell you what, we'll take it from the exempt category, we'll put it in the non-exempt category, and now all of a sudden we have almost a 4% sales tax on this.
On cigarettes,
and so
yeah.
Six people on the city council, mm-hmm. took away the ability for 336,000 to have a vote on policy,
yes.
and on a tax increase. And I thought in Colorado we were supposed to vote on tax increases.
Well, in 1962 is when they made that tax exempt, because that's when the share back that you mentioned happened on cigarettes at the state level with the excise tax. But we still believe that maybe the city of Aurora has kind of back-ended Tabor on this, and we're waiting for a ruling on from the Department of Revenue on that. So we're not done fighting the fight. I mean, we have Glenwood Springs. Of course, I guess I'm kind of elitist. Any place where I have a store, that's important.
but understand, the Department of Revenue, I don't know if they're going to be on your side, and the Colorado Supreme Court hates the Taxpayer Bill of Rights so much, they don't like giving people the power of consent when it comes to taxation.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I think what is happening to your industry and what's happening is wrong. I think it's criminal. I think people ought to know about it.
Mm-hmm.
What should they do?
Well, if you're a consumer in our stores, that we are talking to you about it all the time, via petitions, via letter writing, grassroots type of efforts, and it works, and they do listen. I mean, even the city of Boulder listened, which is almost a miracle. Not everything that we wanted, but it was better than we expected. Age 21, I think that's going to come federally. Fundamentally, I have an issue with a kid that can go to war for us but can't smoke a cigarette or a cigar. But
imagine this.
Or be tried as an adult. I don't know.
Boys, smoke them if you have them. unless you're 19, then you can't.
You can't, but yeah.
Hey, people should go to Smoker Friendly. What an incredible thing. Buy a cigar.
Thank you, John.
Support these folks.
We appreciate that.
Mary, thank you. Stay tuned.